is Mr. Nagesh R. Tambake, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we will discuss unconventional machining, part 2. In that, today we are discussing the electro discharge machining process. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to understand process of electro discharge machining. In this particular session, we are going to discuss electro discharge machining. What is electro discharge machining? Major components, working principle, advantages, disadvantages, and applications. Electro discharge machining. Before going to discuss electro discharge machining, first of all, we'll recall in what category this particular electro discharge machining can be there. Now I will tell you, electro discharge machining is coming in the category of electrical system, because here we are making use of electrical current. Now we'll see what is electro discharge machining. Electro discharge machining is an electrothermal non-traditional machining process where electrical energy is used to generate electrical spark, and material removal mainly occurs due to thermal energy of the spark. Here, EDM is mainly used to machine difficult to machine materials and high strength temperature resistance alloy. EDM can be used to machine difficult geometries in small batches or even on job shop basis. Work material to be machined by EDM has to be electrically conductive. Here, without electrical conductive material, we cannot machine. That is the one of the limitation of this particular electro discharge machining. That we'll see later. But prior to that, we must know whatever the electro discharge machining that we are using, that is only for the electrical conductive material. Now we'll see major components of electro discharge machining. Here there are four major components are there. One is electric power supply. As we have earlier, I told this particular EDM is coming under the category of electrical and thermal system. Here electrical power supply is required. Therefore, we are having electrical power supply over here. Why we require the electrical power supply? Here we need a current that is of high frequency, and this particular electrical power supply can give you high frequency current. Second one is workpiece and tool. Third one is dielectric medium. Dielectric medium here that we are using, that is liquid, kerosene and paraffin, and also sometimes we are using ionized water. And last one is servo control unit. Servo control unit is used for maintaining the gap between tool and the workpiece. Throughout the machining process, servo control unit is maintaining the same gap toward the machining. So here we'll see the setup of the electro discharge machining. Here we are having a power supply. Once again, the power supply negative terminal that is given to the tool, and positive terminal that is given to a workpiece. Here anode is acting like a workpiece and cathode is a tool. And here we are having a servo control system. This system controls this particular gap, whatever the gap is there, that gap is controlling by this servo control system. Here we are having a rack with this tool, and this is the pinion. What happens whenever the machining is going on, that time what will happen? This will maintain the gap according to this control system. Now we'll see what is the working principle of this particular electro discharge machining. So initially, tool and workpiece are immersed into the water, and that time what will happen, as the tool is acting like an electrode and workpiece is acting like another electrode, that time a high frequency current is transferred to the tool, and that time with the help of dielectric medium, the sparks are generated between this particular gap. So during that spark, what will happen? High velocity of spark is generated. Due to that kinetic energy is converted into a heat energy, and lot of heat is generated over here. Remember, 10,000 degrees Celsius of heat is generated over here. That spark is generated. Due to that spark, the material is going to evaporate. Material is going to removed, and that is evaporated. And whatever the sludge is coming over here, that is again removed with the help of dielectrical material. Therefore, there is no question of deposition of the chips over the workpiece. Therefore, we will get high surface finish over here. So we'll see. And here, whatever this rack, this tool is there, the tool is maintaining the gap throughout the machining with the help of this servo control system. Likewise, the machining can occur. And whatever the tool face is there, that is formed exactly opposite to the workpiece shape that is required. Please remember. Likewise, our electro discharge machining process is occurring. Now we'll see again in detail working principle. Here we'll see whatever the current that we are passing with the help of these two electrodes, that is nothing, high frequency current that we are passing, that is called as plasma. Here I have given what is plasma. The concentration would be so high that the matter existing in that channel could be characterized as plasma. Here we'll see, this is the tool and this is the electrical power supply, and this particular whatever the workpiece is there that we have immersed in the dielectric material. Now what will happen whenever the current is passed, that time due to high frequency current, here sparks are generated with the help of dielectrical material. That time whatever the ions are there, that ions is having more temperature. Due to that more temperature, material can be removed. Here you can see during machining, both tool and the workpiece, both are having wearing. So this wear is a low for the tool, because tool is in compressive nature, and therefore here workpiece material is removed more. As workpiece material is softer than the tool, therefore the removal rate of workpiece is more than the tool. Now we'll see some of the advantages for this electro discharge machining. It can be used to machine any material that is electrical conductive. As I already told you, this is only used for electrical conductive material. Non-electrical conductive material we cannot use over here. It can be easily machine thin fragile sections such as waves or fins without deforming the part. Complex dies sections and molds are produced accurately, faster and at lower price. It does not involve contact between the tool and workpiece. So delicate sections and work material can be machined easily without any distortion. It can machine complex shapes which is not manufactured by the conventional machine tools. It is burr free process. As the dielectric material is removing the burr already, so after machining you will get a fine object without a burr. It can produce tapered holes. Some of the limitations or disadvantages are there. The slow rate of material removal rate is there. For economic production, the surface finish specified should not be too fine. The additional time and cost used for creating electrodes for RAM sinker EDM. Reproducing sharp corners on the workpiece is difficult due to electrode wear. Power consumption is very high. Overcut is formed. Excessive tool wear occurs during machining. Electrically non-conductive materials can be machined only with specific setup of the process. Now some of the applications we'll see over here. It is mostly used for mold making and in dye industries. It is used in prototype manufacturing in aerospace, automobile and electronic industries. It is used for coinage dye making. It is used to create small holes in variety of application. It is used to disintegrate parts which cannot be disintegrated easily, such as broken tools, studs, bolts, drills, drill bit and taps, form of workpiece. Here I will recommend some of the books as a reference. One is Workshop Technology Volume 2 by Raghuvanshi, Production Technology by PC Sharma, Production Technology HMT Handbook,